Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again, and today I'm coming to do tutorial, hopefully full tutorial step by step. I'm making for my friend, I'm making something like photofolio slash journal, and it will be from many pieces. It will be some kind of collection. She has a beautiful daughter, Natalie. I made few times babysitter for her, so I know all family really well. And Natalie, it's so gorgeous girl and so funny and so clever, and I really love to do something for them. And I already started. I'm using this gorgeous collection. I've got one in peach colors, I think. Yeah, we've got two colors. This is Blissful Cocoa, and this is Blissful Peach, and I already used this one. And today I'm gonna use this cocoa, and I'm gonna show you what I already made from that peach color. I made this. It's small file folder, photo folder, and Slavka is mom of Natalie. She asked me for something like a photo album, but also with journaling pages where she can write some funny stories, what Natalie did, what Natalie said, and she wanted to give her all this when she will be 18, so then they can go through and they can put all those memories back. And I really love that idea, so I'm going to share with you what I made. This, I'm gonna be very quickly. It's very small photo folder. It will be one of few, and on the top you've got this stink envelope with large pocket here. I used for this file folder, photo folder, I used only envelopes, and I'm gonna show you today how you can change it to journal. Here I put magnet, it's magnetic, so when you open it, you've got another beautiful pocket. When you open this, you've got this selection. I'm gonna move this one on the side so you can better see. You've got this one. All that base is made from envelopes, and I'm going to show you which envelopes I used. Here we've got small pockets. Also here, it's made the same way. Here we've got small pockets. Here are spaces for photographies. Pardon me. Here pockets, space for photography. Here we've got few small pockets like this. Maybe for some notes or small, you know, those profile photographies. When you open it, you've got pocket here, oops, pocket here. You've got two pockets here. One pocket here, one pocket here, also pockets here. And also large pocket here. That's one section. And in that other half, you've got this opening. Here is small space. Small pocket, here is small pocket, space for photography, space for photography, here is small pocket. Here can be put very large, I hope I've got something, very large tag. Oh, it's too wide, very large tag, because it's not glued in middle, so this can go through to that other side. So I've got two pockets here. When you open it like this, you've got pockets here, also pocket here, another pocket here, here spaces for photographies. When you open this one, we've got pocket, beautiful space for photography here, here, here's for small photography, here is like mat for photography. Oh my. Here we've got pocket. This pocket is small, it's like this, but here behind it's very large pocket, it's all down. I will have to put all those photo mats inside, but I want to show you how I made this one. It's made just from envelopes, that base. So hopefully, hopefully I will finish that today. It's second time and I'm gonna try to do this. That first time, it didn't go well. I was jumping. This is what I made before, like this. I was jumping and I a little bit swap what I wanted. So I made this base, and it's made from envelopes as well. Got pocket, pocket, large pocket. this beautiful flap. And it's like this one with pockets here and pockets here. And all this you can use for your journals. You can just put your papers here and make it like maybe your signature, cover for your signature. So I'm going to I'm going to show you how I made it. I used two types of envelopes for this. I used, I think, three for that first one. For that full, for this, I used three envelopes this size. These in England, they are called envelopes C, like Sierra. Charlie. Sorry, Sierra is something different. It's S. C, like Charlie. And its size, when that letter size of paper, you fold it half and it fit on this envelope. So it's that size of envelopes. And then I think seven or eight envelopes this size. These in England, here in England, they are called DL envelopes. And they look like this one. They are those, tall or long. So I'm gonna show you what I made. We're gonna start with this right side of my folder. This is gonna be based of my folder. And I use two envelopes on the side. And because I wanted to make that small pocket here, that short pocket here, I used this long envelope also here. Like this. But I'm not sure if I'm gonna use it now, because I have to cut it a little bit. I don't have those short envelopes, those proper letter envelopes where you fold letter paper on half and then on half again. I'm gonna do it same way like I did that folder before. Hopefully we will get there. So this is gonna be my base, and because I wanna use those beautiful papers from Anna Marie Design, I'm gonna show them to you a little bit how they look like. They are really gorgeous. This is address of website of this amazing shop, Anna Marie Designs. And here you can see, this is Anna Marie Design. Those papers was created by Wendy, I'm not sure how to pronounce her surname, it's Carp or Care. And they are really gorgeous, very shabby chic, beautiful papers with roses, and they are great quality, very strong. Look at these gorgeous papers, really very soft and beautiful. So I really like to do something with those papers. I really like that vanished effect. As you can see, I already started so many with those papers. And because I'm gonna use this color, I'm gonna use I will have to use gathered wings, I think. Okay, I'm gonna use gathered wings today. That will be probably close to what I wanted. I don't have walnut stain. I have to order walnut stain. Okay, I'm gonna use gathered wings today for distressing all edges, for distressing paper. So we're gonna start. As from previous experiences, it's good to build your base on what you want on that backside, and then glued those like flops over. Because here I glued first my envelopes, and they are nicely down. They are laying down nicely, but if she will put there all those photographies and memorabilia, it will be like this, if you know what I mean. So what I found when I did that second one, it's good if you somehow plan what you want and you are already building on this backside page and then glued over these envelopes. So I'm gonna do it that way. I'm gonna glue my envelope. And I want to have here, I think I made, now I made a mistake, did I? I did. Sorry, I'm gonna use it in some other project. I'm gonna take another envelope from Quay. Oops. Yes. Oh God. This is gonna be funny. I'm gonna place my envelope. Probably I will want it here. Yes, like this, to have seen those pockets. And you will have here 1, 2, 3 pockets on the top. So I'm gonna fold my envelope in the size to fit to this gap. I'm not using any scoring board or tool like that. I'm gonna use only my ruler today, scissors, some scalp or cutting knife, pencil, and that distress ink, and also for circles I'm gonna use the sponge, because I will need that for that closure, for that envelope string closure. And I'm not gonna use any scoring board, because it's so many people, so many crafters who are beginners and they don't have that tool yet. So for all of you who don't have any tools, I'm gonna show you how you can create something nice. For all of you who already have all your tools, just use it. Just, you know what to do with it. So use it. It will make your work much more easy and much more faster. So I'm gonna just fold my envelope in size of this. And I think I'm already going to cut it down. Yeah. I'm gonna show you how I will make my envelope. Here it's that fold. If you don't have small envelope for that letter size envelope, how you can do it from bigger envelope. Here is my fold. I'm gonna cut it a little bit by half. I'm gonna open it and I'm gonna cut out all this piece. And I'm gonna leave here this piece. So I'm gonna cut it out. Hopefully I will be successful. Here, I'm gonna cut that corner. And now, this I'm gonna keep here. And now I'm going to cut this out. And I'm gonna create my small envelope. This, from that front size, I'm gonna just fold over and glue down. I've got my small envelope. If you've got small envelope, just use it. But you can use bigger envelope as well and make it to size you need. And I want to keep this flop, the top flop, like my decoration for that second pocket. But I want to have these edges similar. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to fold my envelope on half. But I'm not going to, I'm not going to make fold. I'm just going to put those edges together. Nice and even. I'm going to hold it here. Like this. Nice and even. Good. And with my scissors, I'm going to follow this shape. Like this, and we've got beautiful top. Now I need to distress all these edges and probably fold. Yes, all these edges. I don't need to distress this fold, because here will be decorative paper, but all edges and all these corners. I'm gonna distress now. I'm gonna stop my video because it will be very long. You will have to watch me and I will come back. So I distress all edges, and now before I will glue it down, I wanna put inside some matting paper to make it nice. And I want to have this shape, so I'm gonna not glue it yet. I'm gonna cut piece which will fit inside. I'm gonna cut piece a little bit smaller than it, than is this envelope. I think somewhere here. I'm gonna show you how brilliant it is to have some cutting mat with all this graphite pattern, because now I can place my piece right next to this line. Here I've got my mark, so I'm gonna place it on this cross, and then I'm just gonna follow with my ruler. You know, if I'm lazy to make same mark on that other side with my pencil, so I'm gonna just place my ruler on these lines to make it even, and I'm gonna cut it. This cutting mat, it's fantastic thing. Oops, cut it. So we've got piece which will fit. Which one it is? This one. Yeah, that other one. This one. Yes, it will fit exactly to my envelope, and I don't need piece which will go to down deep down. I need piece just which will cover that top of my envelope. So now I'm going to place my envelope over that paper. Maybe like this, to make these edges even, these small edges even. And here, I'm gonna draw it down, because if I will cut it now with my scissors, I may well move that piece of cardstock and I will cut it wrong. So I'm gonna draw it down around. Oops. Now I'm going to cut these pieces. Like this. Like this. Hopefully we did it right. Show me, show me, show me. Hey, go there. Go there, go there. No. Yes, no, yes. Yes, it will be. Ah, okay. Come again. Oh, mine. Ah, a little bit more here. Come on. A little bit more here. Yes, I forgot that I'm drawing around, so I have to cut a little bit. Oops, a little bit inside of my drawing. So hopefully I'm not going to cut too much. Ah, my son is visiting. Now I'm going to distress all edges. It's so funny. Okay, I'm gonna distress just those top edges. And I'm going to glue it down. Glue it inside. Glue it inside. Slide it in like this. Oh, go there. Hey, come on. You fit before. Good. Oh, yeah. Aha. Oh, mine. And I'm gonna match this top edge with my envelope. Okay. And I've got it here. We've got mat inside. I think I will place it to this position, so I need piece of paper, strip of paper here. And also, I can already put a strip of paper in that third pocket. You don't have to put there a large piece of paper, like go through to that down, because I think no one will open it like this and will have a look what is inside. Everyone will always try to take off anything what will be inside. So I'm going to use probably different piece of paper. I think so. Let me show me. I'm going to have a look which scraps I've got and I will be back. So for my like second pocket, like between pocket, I'm gonna use this beautiful rose paper. And then will be third part. So I already cut piece of paper a little bit smaller than is my envelope here. It's a little bit smaller from both sides. And I'm gonna place it inside because I wanna have this wonderful, a little bit curvy edge. It's not straight, it's a little bit like wave. So I'm gonna place my paper inside of my envelope. I'm gonna take my pencil and I'm gonna draw that template around. And now I'm going to cut this piece and I'm going to cut like inside to make it nice and follow all these lines. And here, small strip like this. I'm gonna use again distress ink and I'm gonna distress a little bit that edge, not too much, just a little bit. Like this. And I'm gonna glue it down already, as you can see that my paper following that line, what I really like, and it's really easy to do it this way. So I'm gonna glue this paper, and you don't have to need paper full size of your envelope, because you will have there another layer, so you need just small piece. I'm gonna glue it down, I'm gonna follow that line of envelope, that large envelope, this line, to make it even, kinda, like this, okay. And now we can glue down this envelope, if we want, like this. Yes, I think, or a little bit down, yeah, I think like this. It will be nice, you can see those roses. So I'm gonna glue it down. I'm going to put glue just on these three edges, and I'm going to position my paper again, my envelope again. Make it even on both sides, like this. Hopefully it's straight. You can take a ruler and you can measure from this line here, which is straight, to this line here, if you got it even. Yep, it's good. Good like this. And we already have three pockets. I don't have anything here. Nice. You've got one pocket here, another pocket here, and here will be third tall, large pocket. I'm gonna put some paper inside. I'm gonna use again my scraps, and I think this time I will see. See, this is nearly similar size. Will I fit inside? I will cut it a little bit. So I need just small strip, nothing too large. So I'm gonna cut it just by my eye. Oh, if I will find my knife. Oh, it ruined somewhere. I'm gonna cut it. And also I'm gonna cut a little bit, just small, because as you can see, it's nearly just small piece from the side. So I'm gonna place my ruler like this. I'm gonna cut small piece, and hopefully now, yes, now it's brilliant. So I'm going to use again distress ink. And as you can see, today I'm wearing bracelets. I've been shopping last week on Sunday market, and I found her amazing crafter. She's making jewelry, so I purchased those bracelets, those two, and I've got also a necklace for this one. It's amazing, it's so gorgeous. It has kind of blue, that turquoise, I'm not sure how to pronounce that. In my language it is turquoise, so I think it's turquoise blue. Something between blue and green, that beautiful, beautiful color. So I've got the same necklace and it's really gorgeous. And I was thinking, oh my god, I totally forgot to look after myself. I'm not wearing those things anymore. And when I found this one, I was like, oh, I have to buy it for myself. And here it has those eyes. I found it first time when I've been in Greece last year with my mommy. And I met there Despina. Hi Despina, how Maria, how girls? I miss you so much. I miss you so, so much. Calimera, girls. I still remember this word. So I found this eye, and it's supposed to be like your guardian, and keep eye on you, and wish you luck, and to all good things. So I took it from that girl as well, on kind of cardboard. I purchased that, not took, purchased that. And I'm so happy, you know. That sound. It's amazing. Now we will put paper on the top, I think. I'm going to use this gorgeous, look at that. And I'm gonna make here probably a layer from these papers, I think. Yes, here. Maybe. Will I? I will. This or this. No. With rose. Yes. Okay. Will I place there roses again? I can place there again those beautiful roses. It will be gorgeous. Okay, I'm gonna take again this rose, shabby chic rose paper. And I'm gonna cut piece large like this one. But before I will glue it, I will show you what I'm gonna do. So I cut my piece in this size, but I'm not gonna glue it down yet. I wanna make sure that I wanna have here some small layout from envelope for another tag like is here. And I wanna make sure that this tab will have lots of space and will be not lift up. Because of thickness of that envelope and those decorative papers. So before I will glue it down, I'm gonna prepare my envelope and cover that envelope with papers, and then just try if my tag, I'm gonna use this shape. If you don't have any dies, you can still make some kind of tabs. Just use the strip of papers, two of them, because it's always better to make these tabs stronger. Some similar strip of paper. Oh, wow. How many words I'm gonna use? Put two together. Similar. I think. Large like this. Cut one side to some shape like this. Then flip that top one, make it even. And cut edge here. Continue in that shape, then flip it over and cut that edge from here. Make sure you've got it put together similar way. Then use some needle or some tool like this. I forgot name. It's for making holes. Make hole where you will put your brads, and that's it. You've got tack. Just distress, glue them together, distress it with your distress ink or any ink you use, put there some stamp, and you've got your tack. This way, it's very easy, and you can glue together 2-3 cards to make it really strong. So I'm gonna use that envelope that I glued before. I'm gonna cut those edges because I wanna use them like pocket. I'm gonna cut those edges. Did I cut it right? Yes, it. So we've got pocket. We've got opening from both sides. And I think if I will put it here, it will be good in this position. So I'm gonna put my envelope right with this edge of that paper to make it straight. And I'm gonna fold it here to make a nice fold here. So I know how large envelope will be, how large envelope it will be. Then, you know, I need to fold it to that size I need. This I'm gonna use like a pocket inside, and this will be over. And this tab will close that. So now I need to cover all the distress, all edges, and cover all these pieces. This will be top, another piece for photographies, and this will be glued down. And it will be like pocket here. So I'm gonna distress all. And I think I'm gonna use again a punch board. Border punch, and I'm gonna use again this one. It's Martha Stewart border punch. I've got it from my amazing friend Evie. Thank you so much, Evie. I'm using it all the time now. It's amazing. I like that shape. So I'm gonna use this border punch for my top pocket, and then I will distress all those edges, and I will come back. So I already put all mats on my envelope. I made this beautiful, gorgeous edge. This is pocket from my envelope. And it's space for photography here, here, and here is that another pocket. I'm gonna glue it down here, but I'm not sure if I will glue down all, or if I will make, you know, again, double pocket. Maybe it will be really nice to glue it down just from here, that corner. And make double pocket here for tack, and maybe here for bigger photo mat. It will be really beautiful. And I'm gonna show you what I meant with that lifting up closure. This is tack what I wanna use. And if I will fit it here, it will go up. I'm not sure if you can see that. I'm gonna try to hold it like this. If I will fit it here with my bra, it's still, you know, it's still like flying in the air, that edge, this one. See? And even if I will fit it here properly, that edge will be up. So I think I will put two circles from cardstock underneath. I'm gonna use my scraps. I'm gonna three. I'm gonna make layout from, oops, I lost it. Layout from my circles. I'm gonna edge them a little bit I'm gonna glue two together right now. And then I will show you how you can fit it to your page. Nice, beautiful edge. I'm gonna make a hole in the middle using my tool, this one. I'm gonna try to make sure, hopefully, here. Yeah, like this. I'm gonna make a hole through to that circle. Like this. I'm gonna take my tack, stamp some words on it. You've got beautiful, this is for planners, small stamps, and I really like them. They are nice and beautiful. So I'm gonna stamp their memories. And for stamping, I'm gonna use Ranger, this espresso. Gonna stamp it like this. Go down. Mm-hmm. Oopsla. Not like this. Ah, like this. Okay. Clear my stamp. Not lost it. Did you ever lost some small stamps? I did many times. I'm not sure how is it possible that they are always falling down from those foils and I'm losing them. And now I'm gonna take one brat. Oh, not two, one. Oh, what are you doing? One brat. Somehow destroyed. I'm gonna put it to my tap and also through to the circle, fix it here. Come on, fix it here. Make sure it can be, yeah, it can be moved. Now I'm gonna glue all these circles together and I will see if that layout of cardstock will be enough. If is it thick enough to make some kind of, you know, maybe I will need to put there one more. This is just teeny, meeny, tiny. So I'm gonna make one more circle and I'm gonna make one more layout here. And then I will place it on my paper. And it will be beautiful embellishment and also that tap will be lie down much more beautifully and flat, not flying in the air, not lifting up. So I'm gonna put one more layout of that circle and I'm gonna be back. So I glued that down, it's a little bit thicker. Now I can glue everything down on that page. I didn't glue this base before, just because if this will be not too thick, if I will use some maybe printed paper, which is not too thick and heavy, it will be that layout much more thinner. Hopefully it's right word, much more thinner. And I will don't have to use those circles and I can fix this tab straight away to this base paper. That's why I didn't glue it down at the first time. But because it's too thick, I'm using this like my base, so I can just glue it on the top. So now I'm gonna glue everything down. I'm gonna put, go, do not glue it to this. This is very easy, really very easy project. It can be brilliant for those craft market for Christmas market, you know. It will be wonderful. Now I'm going to glue this one, and I'm gonna glue it just in this corner, so there will be another space for photomat or for some teeny mini notebook for journaling. So I'm gonna glue it down. Oops, my hands are so shaking. I think I need sugar. You know, I'm trying to rid off so much sugar from my food, and yeah, probably I need a little bit more than I thought. Oops, come on, come on. Be nice like this, yes. And now I'm going to glue down this one. I hope I didn't make a mistake here. And it can be here or here. I think I'm gonna place it here because there I want to have that photomat. So I'm gonna place it here to make sure it will be not on the way for that photomat. And it will still hold this paper. Also, I want to have here some tack. So make sure that there will be space for that tack as well. And it can be open like this and open like this. And it's laying down really nicely. It's not lifting up. So you can make it like this. It's lifting up just a little bit, not too much. It's much more better than before. So now we've got so many pockets here on that page, and we used 3 envelopes. It's one behind, one here. And I think I will put a piece of some decorative paper inside as well. It will be much more better. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pockets from 3 envelopes. And we're gonna continue. Now you can glue those side envelopes, and I'm gonna show you. Because here we've got already some layout. To make sure that your top envelopes will lay down nicely and they will be not lift up like this, you know. When you will put all those photomats or those decorative papers on those envelopes. So now you can place it like here on the top, flip it over and glue it down. Hold it, you know, and glue it down, and it will make here, it will make small spine, and it will be much more nicely laid down. See, here it makes beautiful, nice spine, and it will lie down really nicely and flat. So I'm gonna distress two envelopes. I already prepared 2 pieces, which I will glue, you know, when I will glue those envelopes here and here. And both I will do same way, that I will place them here, flip it over, you know, make sure that they are nicely in middle, flip it over, and then fold, hold it and fold and make spine here, and just glue this one. And similar way, it will be that opposite side. I will put it here, flip it over, and it's good to do step by step both sides. Just decide which side you want to have like top one and start to decorate that envelope. I already cut those pieces inside. I think I will keep them simple, just decorative piece here, and then something on the top. So I'm gonna prepare those 2 envelopes with those 2 pieces of decorative paper, and I will glue them down, and then we will continue. I'm not sure if I will glue down both sides, because this will be decorated with papers as well, but here I don't want to have too much layouts. So I'm gonna do first that left side. I'm gonna distress all edges and put the decorative paper here and inside. This piece will be inside, and I will be back. So I already prepared both of my envelopes from this side. I distressed all edges, and I glued piece of cardstock inside, just small one, not too deep. And here I've got it plain. Both of them are similar way. And I will have them here like this. Because as I said, I'm gonna do left side first and then I'm gonna fold that right side over it to make it nice and flat. So we're gonna first glue down that left side. I'm gonna place it like here, you know, like here. Place it like here. I'm gonna took off this one, so which means this is pretty sticky, but I will put there a bit of glue on that rest of that flap, and I'm gonna fold it over and glue it down. So it's laying nicely. And now here I wanna have like two pockets for tags, but I wanna make it from one piece of paper. So I already prepared piece of paper which is just a little bit smaller than my envelope. Hopefully you will see those edges, just a little bit smaller than my envelope, really a little bit smaller. And I wanna have here just those two half circles like opening for my tags. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna very softly fold it together, not too much. I don't wanna have here that proper crispy fold. I'm gonna use my circle punch and I'm gonna place it kinda in the middle. You can make their mark with your pencil. Just make mark in half and put there your circle punch and punch. And now I will have in the same position those circles. I'm gonna use distress ink also. Not circles, half circles, those cuts. And because I want to have these like two pockets, this piece of paper like two pockets, here I can see where it was folded. I'm gonna put their glue in that middle of my paper. I'm gonna put their glue and I'm gonna put glue all around. And it will make two pockets on my envelope. Now I'm gonna place it on my envelope. Hopefully I will don't move it too much. Hopefully I will place it nicely and even like this. Glue down. Do I have some tags? I'm gonna borrow tags from that previous journal and I'm gonna show you. Here we've got pocket. And here we've got pocket. And now I'm gonna glue that other side, that right side. Again, I'm gonna place it down, flip it over. Make it even. Here you can see where that envelope ended. So in same position, you can check it out again. If you've got it right, you can move it as you need, like this. Yes, flip it over, place it down. put glue on that flap. Still not sure how to collect this lid from envelope. And make nice and crispy edge. It will guarantee you that those envelopes will will lie down really nicely. Here we are. Good. So here you can see, because we made that edge here, those envelopes, even they are decorated, they are nicely laid down. You can use again distress ink and distress all those edges. And I'm gonna do this top of this envelope. Come on. So I already prepared piece of paper. This will be glued down fully. I'm gonna glue it down and I'm gonna make another layout from another envelope on the top. Oops, yeah, come on. Place it nicely. So we've got nearly done this side. Nearly there, nearly there. Take another envelope, that DL, that this one. Glue it together. Cut opposite ends, which will give you two pockets. Again, same way, fold it how you need to, how you want that top layout on this composition. I want to have that bottom part a little bit over edge of this envelope. So I'm going to place it like this. I'm going to place it on the bottom to make it, straight. So I'm going to place it like this. I think this will be okay to go over that edge, and I'm gonna fold it here. I'm gonna fold it here. You can use your ruler and scoring board and score it in that dimension you need. Just count with your ruler how large piece of envelope you need on the bottom and score it on your scoring board. But here I want to show you how you can do it without those all those tools. And I think this is a little bit curvy. I'm gonna use this. I didn't cut it straight. Okay, now it's better. And then I'm gonna distress all these edges. I will do same decoration like is here. Here those half circles. They are not from both sides. Here it's full. And I'm doing it this way. I open this, I'm gonna place my punch inside, and I'm gonna punch half. Oh, come on. And it gives me that opening here, and same way I'm gonna do it from here. I'm gonna open that envelope. I'm gonna slide my punch inside. I'm gonna place it on that opposite side. And I'm gonna punch. This was better. So I've got two openings here, as you can see. Now I'm going to cut pieces for all those sides. Here for inside as well, because here I will see that piece of envelope and I don't want it. So I'm gonna cut piece for inside, piece for top. piece for here and piece for here and piece for inside as well. I'm gonna distress all those edges here, 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 and also I'm gonna save some strip here, because as you can see here, here it needs to be covered with some paper before you will glue it down. So I'm gonna prepare all this and I will come back. So I prepared that base. I've got here strip of paper which will be glued and like peek out over this edge, and I match that with similar paper to make it like continue. I have here strip of paper, I've got here strip of paper also inside, and I want to show you how you can make these cut out if you don't have bigger punch, as I don't have bigger punch. You know, you always have to punch one smaller on your base and then a little bit bigger on your decorative paper. And how to do it kinda easily, I'm gonna show you, and also how you can make pocket here, because this paper, it's shorter than I need. I decide I'm gonna make pocket here. You need some strip of paper, use some your border punch or decorative scissors for one edge, and use your distress ink. And before that, I'm gonna make that half circle punch. I'm gonna move it alongside. I'm gonna place my paper like here. Here I can see edges of my punch. Here you can see it's that half punch. So I'm gonna place it like this, where I will want to glue it down, like this. And I'm gonna make small marks where that half circle ending, like here and like here. I'm gonna take that circle punch, I'm gonna position those marks, maybe you can see them, I'm gonna position them in that my circle punch, and I'm gonna move that paper a little bit more. It will be not half, it will be like 3/4, and I'm gonna punch it, hopefully I'm gonna be okay. Then I need fold these edges together. Don't worry, that paper will be glued down, so you will don't have any folds there. Just hold it here and like continue from here a little bit up. Just cut this sharp, cut out this sharp, like continue with that circle. Just imagine that bigger circle and continue with that. Something like this. Open it and place it like this. It's not the perfect one, but if you don't have bigger punch, circle punch like I don't, this is most easy way how you can make, you know, that between between your pocket and between your decorative paper will be seen that piece of envelope. This is probably more easy way how you can do it. Now we've got here strip of paper which I wanna use to, like my pocket. So I'm gonna fold it. Yes. I'm gonna have a look how big is the paper. I'm gonna fold it over my paper first. Some kind of even. I'm gonna fold it first. Then I'm going to glue down just a first part of my decorative paper to make sure that it will not, you know, fly, it will not move. I'm gonna glue it down like this. Now I need to, you know, like make position, how far I need to go with my extension, with my like second pocket to fit that gap when you've got shorter paper. Somehow, ooh, like this. Yes, like this. I'm guessing. Somehow like this. Lift it up. Put the glue everywhere. Small bit. Glue it down. Still hold it in your hand. Glue it, and glue it down. And if you are using liquid glue, you know, you can still, oops, yeah, move it like me now. And we've got extension pocket, which exactly filled that gap where I didn't have paper. And I forgot to distress it here, so I'm gonna use distress ink here. A little bit. Oops. We've got pockets, pockets, pockets for tags. And now that last part from this top cover, and we need to do also this one. So now that last part, now you need to decide how you wanna glue it down. If you wanna have separate pocket for top tag and for bottom tag, you will need to put glue also here in the middle of your pocket. But I wanna glue it just on sides, so I'm gonna glue this side first. I'm gonna make position like this. I'm gonna glue that first. I'm gonna let it dry a little bit to make sure it will hold. Like this, is it straight? Is it straight? Yes, it's straight. Now I'm gonna open this one. I'm gonna lift a little bit this, and I'm gonna put glue just right there on the end. And I'm gonna glue it down. Yes, you can hear I'm watching alongside Michelle. Michelle Mooney. Paper addiction. The paper addiction. I love her channel. She was the first one I ever saw. So since that, I love her channel, I love her ideas, and I love her journals. They are so gorgeous. So we've got that base. And now we need to do just this flop, and I think we will finish today because it's already, oh my god, it's already 1 hour. So for that flop, I'm gonna use again strip paper to match it together with this pocket. And I'm not gonna do it too big. I'm gonna use like measurement my ruler. I'm gonna make it deep like this probably. I think it will be enough. So I'm gonna cut strip exactly like is my ruler. I'm gonna place it on this edge. But you can make strip wide as you want. This is 5 centimeters, this ruler. So I'm gonna cut strip 5 centimeters wide. Also, some paper from the bottom part, and I'm gonna use this again. So again, I'm gonna place my ruler on the edge. I hope it's straight. And I'm gonna cut a strip of paper that's 5 centimeters wide, like this. Now I need to cut it gonna place it. Not bigger than is my envelope, just a little bit smaller than is my envelope. So I'm gonna make mark here. You know, you can take your ruler, have a look how many centimeters or inches it is. It is 16, so I'm gonna make small mark here, put it together. Yep, come on. Like this. Put those two together. Nice and even. And use my scissors and cut it here. Like this. And because I want to have, I'm gonna show you again with a little bit decorative corners, I'm gonna again fold it. It will be glued like this. So I'm gonna again fold it together like this. Just make sure all your corners will be nicely together, even together. Take your scissors and make beautiful corner. You can use your decorative scissors, you can use some corner punch, but I'm okay with this one. Distress all edges. Also here. Take your base. I'm gonna move, oops, all this on the side. Take your base, oops, and first we're gonna glue down this bottom paper. So I'm gonna place it straight with this fold, like this. Make sure those edges are even, that those gaps between edge of this paper and edge of envelope and here on that side are even. Place it straight to here. Put glue on the envelope flap. Put it there. Put glue here on that edge because there can be some gap between and you will don't like if your paper will be not glued properly. Like this and fold your envelope flap, glue it down, and now glue down this top paper. Nicely cover that bottom paper with your top paper, glue it down, make it flat, and we're done. We need to do tags, photo mats, or maybe some embellishment if you want some more embellishment, and we are done. We have pocket here, or pocket, like space here, beautiful space here. We've got pocket here. We've got pocket here. We've got pocket here. We have pocket, large pocket here. We've got two pockets here with tags. We've got large pocket here. When we open this one, we've got pocket here. Pocket here. I have to put one more decorative paper. And also, if you will place some decorative paper inside in this envelope, you can make it a little bit longer than is that envelope. I'm gonna show you, this is smaller, but I'm gonna show you what I mean. If you will make it like peek out, if you will make it nicely same size to fit it inside, and if you will make it a little bit peek out, and it will be different type of paper, it will be much more easily to see where is your pocket here. So I'm gonna do it. We've got also a pocket behind. We've got pocket here, and large pocket here. So this is for today because it's really, oh my God, it's nearly midnight. I'm going to sleep. I'm going to sleep. I didn't drink too much today, so I start to have headache, I think, from not drinking at all. I will have to take some water. So we finished that. Backside of our file folder, and in next video hopefully we will finish this first page. So we didn't cover that backside yet because there will be, you know, spine, which I wanna show you how you can make it like a journal as well. So this is all my sharing for today. Maybe, hopefully, I gave you some idea. Hopefully, hopefully it was helpful. I know it's too long, so I wish you good night. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for all your amazing comments, for your support. Thank you so much for all amazing videos about file folders and photo folders, because from there I'm taking so many ideas. And have a beautiful day, have a beautiful night, and see you next time. Thank you so much. Bye.